Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for waiting. Apologies, we are slightly delayed because of sir was extremely engaged with all the startups who were actually demoed today. So thank you so much for that. And I know that sir, a few things we had to mention. One of the reasons why we arranged a graduation ceremony, and that too an in-person one, was sir, because we hear a lot about the problems that a lot of women entrepreneurs have faced and they faced during the pandemic. So now we wanted to actually present to you the technology-enabled startups that we have incubated. And the second thing we wanted to highlight with our graduation event is that when we hear a lot about all the challenges that women entrepreneurs are facing, these are the startups which actually persisted through the incubation program. They diligently attended every virtual session. They pivoted beautifully, and they are now successful startups who have actually grown in customer base. They've grown in the product, the way they have been able to diversify, and they've also contributed immensely to adding more employee numbers as well, sir. So we wanted to celebrate the entrepreneurs, and we're really thrilled that JS sir and you could actually spend some time with all of our entrepreneurs and also encourage them further. So without further ado, I will request JS sir to speak a few words.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Deepti, Honorable Minister, attendees, participants. My heartfelt congratulations to all of you for very successfully completing your incubation program and reaching a stage where you are ready to go to the market, seek customers, and grow your business. We saw almost 20 startups demonstrate their solutions, their ideas, their products, and I can tell all of you without any hesitation that these are some of the best quality work that I have seen in recent times. So I would like to really congratulate you. I appreciate three things about what I saw. One is the choice of your line of activity. You are very precise. You have identified an existing niche, an existing pain point, and you have been able to very successfully identify a solution which addresses that pain point. So your selection of your line of activity is very commendable. And the design of your solution, the simplicity, the user experience, that is again something which I really appreciate, because I have seen so many other startup pitches, and I do notice that while the idea is good, there are some gaps in execution. The idea has not been translated perfectly into something which the customer can straight away use and adopt. But I noticed that most of you, in fact, literally all of you, have come up with very good user experiences and simple designs and affordability, etc. The third thing which, when Honorable Minister was meeting you and interacting with you, as you saw, he was instantly able to think of opportunities that you can be connected to this or that or that. And there are umpteen such opportunities. So the key now for you, now that you are ready to go to the market, is to be very agile in scanning the horizon, identifying where are opportunities possible, and be very aggressive about seeking out those opportunities. And as Honorable Minister pointed out, the government will always be there to help you access those opportunities. Whatever is the best that we can do, we will always be there. Just because you have completed your incubation, it doesn't mean that we have nothing to do with you. You will remain an alumnus of V-Hub, and we will remain continuously responsible for your business development, for your growth, etc. So congratulations to all of you. This was a brilliant demonstration, and good wishes and good luck. Thank you. I would request Honorable Minister to address all of us.
Thank you, Jayesh. Thank you, Deepti. To all the wonderful young women-led startups, about 47 of them who are graduating, firstly, my compliments, my congratulations. I think what I've seen really was mind-blowing. In fact, I honestly, when I walked in, I wasn't aware or familiar with the range of products, with the range of ideas that I would probably be interacting with today. I was really blown away by some of the ideas because truly startling, truly astounding innovations, and truly useful. Not doing something for the sake of being innovative, but doing something really that matters to the society at large as well. I met a couple of biomedical engineers who looked at healthcare sector and said, this is a problem that we would love to solve. I also looked at a young lady from Chennai. She's here, and she talked about a startup problem, cage culture, in oceanography, how you can help fishermen. While we are an inland location, while we are a landlocked location, I think the fact that you have come here and chosen to incubate in a state like Telangana speaks volumes about the ecosystem here, about the government playing an enabler, the role of an enabler here. Met a lot of other brilliant young minds. We met a drone manufacturing company, I think Haripriya. Haripriya is the young lady who founded this company. I keep forgetting the names of the companies. I'm getting old, so I obviously don't remember as well. So again, brilliant innovation. The size of your drones was mind-blowing, actually. Thank you very much for the opportunity to interact with you and others as well. Many, 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 many young women who had brilliant ideas, who had, the ability to dream big is what sets an entrepreneur, an innovator, apart from others. India is a very young country, as you all know. We're a very, very young country. And I'm certainly not part of that generation or part of that population. Our median age, if you look at it, more than 50% of India is actually on the median age of 27. And if you take a look at the 65% population mark, we are at the age of 33. Now, that's a very, very young country. So the opportunity to actually come out with products, innovations which can help not just our country, large country, 1.3 billion, but also the opportunity to actually now dabble and interact with people all over the globe, with technology being all pervasive, presents you an opportunity which none of the previous generations has ever had. This is a very unique opportunity for you guys. I think you have to leverage it. You have to ensure that this ecosystem that has been created, you take full advantage of it. One of the things I can think of immediately is that, like Jayesh Ranjan Garu pointed out, the government of Telangana will be, if your product is useful for the society at large and for the state at large, we'll be your first customer. We'll give you that first proof of concept, first pilot, so that you guys can at least dabble, understand what it really takes, and then from there on, we can see how you actually fare in the market and in the world at large. The second thing I would like to point out, besides the government being your first customer, we will also do the needed spade work to connect you to the right kind of people, to connect you to the industry. So, for example, there was one young woman who wanted to manufacture in the medical devices park here. I think she's from Delhi or Mumbai, but she's chosen to incubate in Hyderabad, incorporate here. So we'd be happy to facilitate that conversation, ensure that she actually sets up a manufacturing facility right here. There was Deepthi, who actually, I think, went to Madras. You said your alumni is IIT Madras, is it? So she's chosen to work here, has come out with a very unique product. In current pandemic, where people are worried about the kind of products we use, she's come out with a unique product which kind of helps you prevent infection and spread, and prevent the pandemic from being from the spread. So there are lots of brilliant ideas, lots of lovely thoughts. In fact, I also loved the idea of bringing our women who are educated but are not currently part of the workforce. There was a startup, I think Nishtha it was. She had an idea to give information to these young women so that they can actually plan their own enterprises, pursue their own dreams. So many, many such ideas. I think many, many wonderful things that I have witnessed today. I'm blown away by the diversity. I'm blown away by the range and the ambition that you young ladies have exhibited. So my best wishes. 47, I was told, is the total startups that are graduating today. Compliments to all of you. I hope the first women-led unicorn from India, I hope, will come from Hyderabad, will come from V-Hub. So my best wishes to you, all of you, and those of you who I have not named, or those of you whose products I did not talk about, my apologies, because I obviously, like I said, I'm old now and my memory is fading, so please forgive me in advance. But my compliments, congratulations on a wonderful job, and my compliments to the entire team of V-Hub as well on a very thoughtful program. In fact, while we were upstairs, we launched a couple of very unique initiatives also. We also want to catch our youngsters fairly young. So a new program with schools has been launched, where five schools are partnering and will encourage innovation from a very young age, from high school age. And then we also launched another program with young women in colleges, in women's colleges. Another five colleges have chosen to be a part of this. So we'll be training the trainers, we'll be working with the young students in data sciences, in entrepreneurship, in business management. So all of these initiatives, I think, will continue to grow WeHub into a much, much better facility for young women all over India. I think have met two young women who are not from Hyderabad, who have chosen to move to Hyderabad, relocate to Hyderabad, and launch their enterprise from here. My compliments to all of you. Good luck. Best wishes. Thank you very much for this opportunity.
నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, కామెంట్ చేయండి, అలాగే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసి పక్కనే ఉన్న గంట సింబల్ ప్రెస్ చేయడం అసలు మర్చిపోయి